Hey guys, in this video we're going to be exploring something new and trendy, and this is the effect called neumorphism. So in this video we're going to recreate these two particular layouts with these two different neumorphistic looks, and I'm going to show you how I applied them using Elementor Pro. So if you are using Elementor free, well, bad news, but for Elementor Pro users there is a super easy way to apply this effect for your layout, for your elements, but we're going to be using some custom CSS, so there are no settings in the Elementor editor that allows you to do that. This is why we're going to need to apply some custom CSS, but all that we'll be using is only a box shadow. Box shadow is supported across all the browsers, but if you want to make sure that you also provide the same experience for the users with older versions of some browsers, you can also use Moz and WebKit prefixes for your code. And all of the code snippets are going to be available in the description section or in the comments. Anyways, you can simply copy and paste it in your own editor. Now, for those of you who haven't heard of this trend, let's actually have a look at what it is and what it looks like and what it all started with. Well, actually, this trend started on Dribbble, and it all started from there. All designers started picking it up and making some concept designs using this particular look. And a lot of people do like it, but even more people do see a huge problem with this kind of look, because of how little contrast it actually has with the background. So the key components to a neumorphistic, I'm not sure if it's an actual word, but the key components to a neumorphism look is that your object has to have the same color as your background, and you also use two kinds of box shadows. So you add two layers of box shadows. One is darker, which is like a shadow, and the other is lighter, which is more like a highlight. This is how you create this kind of look, like this object is a part of your background and is kind of protruding from the surface. Essentially, these are all very basic bevel and emboss effects, and they're available in any software, and this kind of look has been around quite a while, and the fact that they just pick it up and call it neumorphism is something new for the interfaces, for the UI design. It is something new, but not completely new. Alright, anyways, now let's see in what cases it actually works and in what cases you shouldn't go for it. So in this case, with this card, it actually does work because it does create this distinction between the card and the background. But it is not crucial for us to see this contrast. What you shouldn't do is apply this effect to a button and hope that it's going to be enough for the user to understand it's a clickable button. Because here you see he's not using this look, these shadows, for this button. This button, it's clear that this is a button, it's a clickable button, it has a traditional button look. Another example, this one is a pretty good design, you see it is working with these cards, but I wouldn't recommend doing it with things like buttons, maybe icons, or other clickable objects that have to be clear for the user that they are objects that they can interact with. So for the cards, maybe for some graphic elements, it's a great and very interesting way to spice up your design, but not for the elements that are interactive. So now let's jump back to our Elementor editor and see how we can create this effect ourselves and apply it to our objects. The thing is that, as I've said, it is great to use for cards and for some minimalistic layouts like these. So these are the looks we'll be going for. Right now, let me delete all of the effects that I have already on these cards so we can create the effect from scratch. So there we are, here is the look that you get with all the default settings. And the thing is that my background here is not completely white. It is something grayish. By the way, the widget that I'm working with today is simply a post widget in Elementor Pro. Here it is. And to start recreating the neumorphistic look, what we need to do is to first pick the CSS class of our cards. It will be way easier to do if we start out when we can clearly see where our cards are, where we can clearly distinguish between the card and the background. I'm going to jump to the preview right now. And I'm going to click F12 so it opens my inspector, and I'm going to grab this inspect thingy, and I'm going to hover over one of my cards and click on it. So what we have to do here is to find where the class of one individual card is. Here we are, and you have to make sure that you target only one post and not the container of your layout. And this is what we have. Once I click on it, it selects the entire class, and we actually have to grab it and copy it, the entire thing, just to make sure that we target this specific set of cards on this specific page. And you just copy it, and you get back to your editor. You make sure you select your widget, go to Advanced, Custom CSS, and just paste it in here and leave it there just for now. And now we're going to proceed to all the other things we have to have sorted out before we start writing the code for the neumorphism look. Alright, so what do we need to do here? First thing is to change the background of the card so it matches the color of the background on our page in the actual container. Well, to do that, let's go to Box, Background color, and here I have it already in my palette. Now the next thing we need to do is to round our corners, and we'll do it using border radius 15. Now the last thing we have to do is to disable the box shadow for your objects, if you have any, because this setting will overwrite everything that you write in the custom CSS tab. So if you have it enabled, simply disable it and make sure you get no shadow on your objects. Now back to Advanced, and in custom CSS we already have this class pasted. Now let's start writing the actual styles for our box shadows. As I've already said, you can simply copy the code snippet down in the description box and paste it in your own editor. First we will write the shadow, which is darker, and then the settings for the highlight. It is black and it has only 10% opacity, but you can increase it if you want, if this is the look you're going for, but I wouldn't recommend doing that. So basically this is what it is. And now let's do the same thing, but let's add prefixes. So if you copy and paste this code, this is what it's going to look like. But now let's also write the styles for the hover state. So this is how you do it. You simply add a semicolon and hover after it. And then you copy the box shadow thing here. And what we need to do is to just increase this values a little bit, so it seems like the card is floating above the background a little bit higher. Done, now let's test it out. There we are. Now same thing. Just copy and paste the same lines with the two different prefixes. So we also make sure it works for the older browsers. And it's also considered proper CSS if you bring the standard property below the properties with the prefixes. So that's it with the first look, let's move on to the second one. Now our second case is this countdown timer, and we're gonna apply a little bit different style to it. Now as you remember, we gotta go and find out what the class of each of these cards is. So let's jump back to the preview. Now let's inspect this element, and what I will do is copy it here up to this part, which seems to be the exact class of the objects that I need, and we'll make sure this widget is selected and go to custom CSS and paste it here. What do we got to do here? Border radius. Bring it up to 15 and change the background color so it matches the color of our background. As for the border, what we could do is to try and experiment and leave 1 or 2 pixel white border here and see what difference it makes and how different the effect will look. Now in custom CSS, I'll simply paste the same styles that I had for the cards above. For the normal state, it's not going to be different at all. It's going to be the same settings, the same look. But for the hover state, it's going to be actually a little different. Now let's copy the class state hover and write the following. Inset means that our shadow is now going to be inside of its container. And I'm also going to bring the opacity down to 5%. There we have it. I don't know about you, but this border is not really working for me. Maybe something like this. But okay, let's get rid of it entirely. This is how you can create this sort of look with Elementor Page Builder and a tiny bit of custom CSS. Just make sure you target the right class of the right objects on your page and you shouldn't have any problem. Now in the mobile and tablet view, it's also performing quite well. And there also shouldn't be any device specific issues. Well, this is pretty much it for this video, and now you know how to bring a little bit of neomorphism to your design. And I hope this video was helpful for you and you learned something new or at least had fun along the way. Anyways, if you liked the video and you want to see more tutorials like this one, let me know in the comments and we'll make it happen. By the way, talking about trends, on templatemonster.com we have a lot of new entries with cool trendy design. You don't want to miss it. Go and check this out. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. See you around.